वंदे गुरु वंदे गुरु वंदे गुरु वंदे गुरु वंदे गुरु वंदे गुरु वंदे गुरु
So I invite Pramod Mahajan sir to introduce our chief guest.
Good evening and Vande Gurum to all. Today we are here for another very impressive and impactful training session, flipped classroom, flipping of thought process, flipping of technique strategies, curriculum and syllabi. It's a futuristic aspect. So we all welcome our honorable resource person, Dr. AP Sharma, all our board of directors of CEIR, all the zonal directors, premium members, principals, and all the participants and edu leaders. You all welcome for this flipped classroom session, and trust me, after these sessions definitely there will be a flipping in your thought process, your action, and from tomorrow onwards you will be flipping your style also. Let us discuss about CEIR. CEIR, Center for Education Initiative and Research. It's a forum of experts and scholars who aim to nurturing the talents, making the students as well as educators future fit, futuristic one. This is the forum where change happened. This is the forum where skilling happened. This is the forum where upgradation happened. CEIR has an efficient board of directors, zonal directors and premium members from throughout the India as well as from the Middle East. We have completed 3 webinar series with 14,000 participants, 15 webinar series with CBSC official, more than 1 lakh participants, 116 webinars in 365 days, 64 principal teachers webinar, 7 pathway career guidance program, 26 handwriting made easy programs. Veda handwriting is another impactful and impressive venture of CEIR. Veda handwriting deals with the handwriting of the students, which reflects their personality, which reflects their self-esteem, which affects their confidence level, make them more confident, and even enhance their marks. It's a common observation that during these online classes, it's very difficult for the teachers to take care of that handwriting which reflects the personality, academic excellence of a child. So Veda Handwriting Lab has come up with a nice solution with the well-crafted training kit with a personalized student's application to help them to acquire neat and legible handwriting. See, the handwriting ensures your psychomotor skill, fine motor skill as well as gross motor skill. And if your psychomotor skill is enhanced, cognitive skill and affective skill get synchronized. So that is the way the handwriting lab. CIR has come up with different other ventures. The Mark of Excellence Award 2021, where the outstanding schools will be awarded and it will be completely based on the merit. We are coming up with various training sessions. Today's training session is about flipped classroom, design thinking, 25 ways of teaching with talking less, competency-based learning, project-based learning, action research, collaborative learning, and teacher as an instructional leader. We are there to enhance your pedagogical aspects. We are there to make your future fit. We are there to support you for all sort of those aspects which are required in the sphere of education. Together we can, and together we will. So that is about the CER and their various activities. Visit our vedahandwritingkit.com/campusconnect for getting your handwriting a next step ahead. No registration fees for the Mark of Excellence Award, completely merit based. These are the various aspects which we deals with. Our NEP series or NEP quiz has created a milestone in the field of webinar series. Now people are saying that webinar series get defined or well defined by NEP series of CEIR, NEP quiz of CEIR. Authorities from CBSC, Secretary, Controller of Examination, Director of Academics, they have visited and they have witnessed that yes, we are the one who are turning each and every stone which is hurdle in the path of the success of the leaders, educators, students, and all the stakeholders. There are many sessions we do organize for parents as well as for the students. Coming to today's our presenter, our resource person, our expert for the flipped classroom, Dr. AP Sharma, Anand Prakash Sharma, जो कि नॉलेज से प्रकाशित करते हैं और सबको आनंदित भी करते हैं. साइंस ग्रेजुएट, एमफिल इन इकोनॉमिक्स, फ्रीलांसर जर्नलिस्ट, हैविंग एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ 3 decades, बट हिज एक्सपीरियंस इज डू समथिंग न्यू एवरी ईयर, नॉट लाइक दैट डू समथिंग फॉर 1 year एंड रिपीट इट अनदर 29 years. शर्मा जी एक्सपीरियंस इज एवरीथिंग, एवरी ईयर समथिंग न्यू beyond the box. Curriculum strategist, CBSC award winner, national award winner by HRD minister in 2010. In 2014, national award from President of India, global teachers award in 2015, award for women empowerment from UNESCO and Delhi Commission for Women 2016. Academician of the Decade from WEF 2016. Exemplary Leadership Award from Honorable Pranab Mukherjee in 2018. And many more awards and laurels. Founder member of Academic Committee of Qatar. Authorized and authored many articles on education and parenting aspects, conducted more than 300 workshops for parents, principals, and teachers. He is an expert of design thinking. With his design thinking mode of operation today, he is going to flip the thought process of all of us with the knowledge which he has gained working with MIT USA, Netherlands in last 7 years. Member of CBSC Exam Reform Committee in 2016, Curriculum Committee in 2018, Mark Scheme Committee in last 15 years, CBSE Inclusive Education Committee 2018. He had been a member in Niti Aayog. So a person who is an expert for design thinking, member of a Niti Aayog, taking care of the examination, has a reach in the curriculum aspects, will going to flip all of us today by his session. Honorable Anand Prakash Ji Sharma. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Mahajan Ji. You made me humbled by adding so many words, but please remember, after all, I am also a teacher. And whatever I achieved in my life, you can achieve more than that. Because I realized it at the age of 38 to do great things and innovative things when I became principal at the age of 36 or something like that. And many of you can achieve all these goals right from beginning. So, honorable, all the board members of CIR, especially I can see Shishanji, Bindu ma'am, many journal directors are there. Mr. Bhavik, I can see. If I'm missing few names, please forgive me. But yes, of course, when I was given this particular opportunity by Shishan sir said, Sharma ji, aapko karna hai ye. I was engaged in some other webinar, which is at 7 o'clock in some other country. So I said, no, sir, aapki baat hum mana nahi kar sakte. And then I have good friends over here, Mr. Mahajan and all. And please remember one thing, that all of you can do amazing things. But first of all, you should know that you don't know anything like me. What does it mean? If you know that you know so many things, then you can't add. This means if your glass is completely filled, then you can't add even a drop of water. So you have to unlearn something and you have to behave like a student in this particular class. So I'm making some rules of this class. First of all, keep one or two pages, means simple copy pages, used one or unused with you, and a pencil, okay? What you can do that whenever you learn something good, so on that particular plain paper, you can make a petal of the flower, correct? Circle and petal of the flower. Whenever you learn second one, one more petal, and I would like to see towards end how many petals and how many flowers you will have. And these flowers I will present to you. And that will be a gift from you to yourself. That is, remember one thing, nobody in life will appreciate you until and unless you start appreciating yourself. So you must appreciate yourself, then you gain so much confidence and you can achieve anything in life. I won so many awards and all, this is recognition, and I never tried to win these awards. Just I kept doing my things, and by chance that time CBSE was not asking applications and all. Their search team used to send the application, ki, Mr. Sharma, you have been selected by the search team, so present your things and all. But all of you have great potential, but before that, you have to become a student. So one thing is okay. I hope now everybody is having one paper also. Fine. Now, second thing which Mr. Mahajan likes very much, that is that I have conducted few principals workshop, and in one or two, Mr. Mahajan was there. And he says that, aha, oho, to jarur karana hai. What does it mean? The class should remain live. It should not happen that all of a sudden Anju ma'am has gone to sleep, or just she has stopped video and then doing something, or Sunita ma'am is yawning. It should not happen. So what is the idea? That in between, I will be asking you, aha. Aha means, spelling is, write down, A-A-H-A, aha. I will ask aha. I will not write aha. I will ask aha, and you have to reply in the chat box, oho, O-H-H-O. And if I ask, if I say aha ha, a ha ha ha, then you have to say oh ho ho, correct? Spelling should be correct. The spelling of oh ho ho is oh ho oh ho. If this would have been a live thing means we would have been in a hall, and if I would have been conducted, you would have enjoyed more. Kyo Mahajan ji?
Yes, sure. We enjoyed a lot.
Sir, one small request, sir. Now we have enabled all the participants to operate their microphone, but please be a little careful. They can anytime they can operate it from on and off it from their side, sir. We made it like that.
So you want that I say aha, so they can.
They should say oh.
Let's
make a noise today.
Yeah, we can start like that. 4 o'clock, 4:30, we can start like that. Your wish.
Sure. And the third thing is that I will be giving you a little bit class work that is required. Class should be busy, then only it works. So first of all, I must tell you, whether it's a flipped classroom or any other classroom, it's very important that you connect to all the students. So the first important lesson of life is connect. If you are teaching somebody, then connect. In lesson plan also, connect is not written, but you have to connect. How to connect? Like whenever I used to go to class, some class, what happens, you will find different kind of students. There are few students, they are saying, good morning, ma'am. And there are 3-4 students at the end, they do not speak at all. There are 4-5 students, they are saying, good morning, ma'am. This means these batteries are not fully charged. There are some batteries which are fully charged. There are some batteries which are half charged, and there are few batteries which are not charged at all. So if you want to teach, follow up, first of all, you have to charge them. And once you will charge them, then everybody is ready to receive. They are charged, so they will receive. So the effectiveness of classroom is this. Like I have various kind of things. Like I go to classes and I go to assembly. And even if I take a principal's meeting or principal's workshops or teacher's workshop or even parents' workshop, I ask them, like first one is, I told you, aha, oho. Second one is, shakalaka, boom, boom, I said, and they say, boom. I say, shakalaka, they say, boom, boom. I say, boom, boom, they say, shakalaka. I say, shaka, boom, they say, laka, boom. So interesting things. So what happens that anybody who is not replying, I go to him and ask question. So even once, what happened, there was our education minister was there and he was talking on phone when I said, aha, ha. He did not reply. So I reached him and I asked one question. He said, Mr. Sharma, sorry. And next time when I said, aha, he raised his hand and loudest voice, he said, oh, ho, ho. So here we have to go with that particular thing. So let us try. Shishanji had been very kind. So you can unmute yourself for one second.
Yeah.
Parikh sahab, aapke student nahi banna hai kya?
Yes, sir.
Oh, ho.
Is it together or
together?
Okay, sir.
We can't hear anything. We can't hear anything. Please kindly mute everyone.
Yeah. Just for 1 second.
1 second only.
I'm asking you.
Sir, now you unmute from your side, sir. Sharma, sir.
So now I am unmuted and you are on mute. So I am giving you one simple exercise. Okay, please try to make a boat, paper boat, which he used to make, I think many a times he would have made. So make a paper boat. Right, I'm giving you 30 seconds. The boat which you have seen, in which you have traveled, that kind of boat. I can see Swamini ma'am is making very fast. Sunita Viz madam is also making very fast. Oh, Mahajan sir is also trying. Good. Okay. Madhavi ma'am is trying.
Lakshmi. Done, sir.
Done? Good, good, good. Very nice. So I hope everybody has made it. Mahajan sir, aapki board dikhana jara.
Yeah. It is flying. It is flying with the air.
Okay, now please check. I gave you one instruction. The instruction was that you have to make a boat, that kind of boat which you would have seen in life, the real boat. And also, you would have traveled in that boat. Now check your boat. Have you seen this kind of boat any time in life? No. Because I asked this question in a principal's workshop with 1500 principals, and not a single principal made a boat which he had seen. Why? Because we had some prejudices in his mind. What are these prejudices? That what we made long back, we will not listen other thing. So what we will do, we will start making. So you have made a boat which you have never seen, and you would have not traveled with. I hope in everybody's boat there is, in the center there is a triangle. Correct. But this kind of triangle you would have not seen in an actual boat. It could have been made very easily. You remove that triangle or you sideline that triangle by folding. Gone. So first of all, you have to leave your prejudices. So what happens that sometimes we become stereotype. Not sometimes. Most of the times we become stereotype. And when we become stereotype, whatever is in our subconscious mind, that answer only comes. But not necessarily that every time we should give same answer. We should not give same answer. We should try to think. We should try to listen. But our listening skills are very poor. We don't listen because we are principals. We are teachers. We are to teach. We should not listen. Mahajan sir, note another day is in Delhi, there were around 900 principals. And then I told them to make something and none of them could make that particular thing because they don't listen carefully. So please remember, all prejudices of your subconscious mind should go and listen carefully. I may ask you two or three such questions in between. So next time you think and make, listen carefully. Okay, listen very carefully. So now we will start our session. Flipped learning. And flipped learning was happening for last more than 1.5 years. I will share my screen. So again, I'm reminding, you have to make flowers. I'm quite sure I can see Mahajan sir has already put up 3 petals and Pratiksha ma'am has already put up, Pratiksha Dikshit ma'am has put up 2 petals. So keep, try to make petals. And if you can write what you have learned, I think the most important lesson till now, you have learned 2 things very important. Connect. Very important in classroom, there should be connect. Second thing is, one more important thing is that we have to leave our prejudices. We have to leave our prejudices. That only we can come out. So on flipped classroom, there had been many, many workshops throughout India. I think in last year, more than 1 lakh such kind of workshops would have been there. When they will explain what is flipped classroom and all, but this workshop is altogether different. We will make it together more interesting. Let's move to the next slide. So why flipped classroom? Now see, from September onwards, particularly in India and Gulf countries, there will be a kind of classrooms in which government will allow only 30% students or 50% students strength, correct? So this means not full class will come to the school. Half of the children will remain at home and half of the children will come to school. Now, second thing is most important thing. Nobody would have told you about this, that what you do when you have 40 students, then divide them in 2 groups. If you have 30%, then divide them in 3 groups. How will you divide? You will divide them gifted, all gifted students together, above or average students together, and special need students in 3rd group. Special students in 3rd group. I would like to see in chat box few answers where you will mention that what is importance of that, what is importance of this grouping. Anyhow, we will keep doing it. Again, I am repeating, you will group. You will not say that 1 to 15 come on one day and 15 to 30 come on another day. Then your purpose is defeated. just I was sharing this particular aspect with few schools in Iran, and they liked it very much, and they did it very second day. So this grouping is very much important in flipped classroom. Third thing is somewhere spelling is resource limitation and purposeful engagement necessary. Now, since there are 50%, 30% students coming, so you have to involve all students, but physically only 30 or 50% are present in the classroom. We have to engage those also who are at home. But here there are two models. Let me tell you, in Gulf countries also, there are few schools, what they are doing, that when they are teaching few students, means suppose say 50% students in classroom, simultaneously, what is happening? That they are broadcasting that particular lesson to the students who are staying at home. But that will not be that much effective. You know, somebody is sitting in the classroom and somebody is sitting at home. There is a big difference. But there is a digital divide in India, and maybe that for many schools, this is not possible, that simultaneously they can teach 50% students in classroom and 50% students at home. So for them, flipped classroom is the beautiful idea and beautiful answer to this particular problem. Now, what you need to do, why 50% students? To maintain social distance, syllabus is generally reduced. You know, CBSE reduced the syllabus, and this year also we will listen very soon that they will be reducing syllabus. But remember, syllabus reduction does not mean to touch curriculum. What does it mean? I will tell all the principals and teachers that please try to teach them everything, whatever is in curriculum. What you can do for few things, you can do note, you can give notes. Few things you can touch superficially, but touch everything. Otherwise, in their foundation, that brick, that gap will remain. And whatever building they will make in life, that will be incomplete. So what I want to say, even if they reduce syllabus, you try to give some kind of aspects, some kind of literature, some kind of videos to students for self-learning, and tell them this will not be asked in examination. Now, to have practicals and collaboration, that is also important. Then better exploring and less class strength. Self-learning with self-pace. This is one beautiful thing. Here you can explain and you can understand how various children can be given various kind of aspects of self-learning. So I'm giving you a model. In this model, teacher need not work extra. Teacher need not work hard. I don't like hardworking people. I like smart working people. There is a difference between smart work and hard work. What smart work means is hard work also, but with a certain kind of efficiency and certain kind of goals. I hope many of you would be knowing the meaning of smart. Smart, S-M-A-R-T. You try to find out on Google, I will be asking you in between, because that will be very nice to know about this. But I will give you some idea. As for a specific goal, M for measurable, A for attainable, R and T you find out. T also I will tell you, time bound, R you have to find out. Maybe reasonable or something like that. So everything should be smart. That's why from now, try to tell students also and try to tell yourself also that we have to do smart work. But please remember, I don't want to say that smart work is and hard work is a comparison. Smart work is a hard work smartly, correct? Coming to next. So what is the model flipped teaching at home and at school? So teacher and student, what teacher will do? Create video lectures and share with the students. This means these are those lectures which teacher is preparing, maybe in a previous class, they can have the recording and they can give to next batch after the class in afternoon. So children, those who are expected to come next day will have some kind of video lecture before. So when they come to school, they know what is going to be taught and they can ask certain kind of questions. Share with the students. At school, what will happen? Facilitate discussions. Now these children have seen the video. Already they have seen the video. So in classroom, there will be more discussion. There will be in-depth learning. very important thing, please remember, in flipped classroom, what happens? That speed is affected. Means the syllabus will, you will find that the pace of the syllabus covering is half. So here, when you have already taught them and they have got the video, you have now discussions and answer a student's question. So speed somewhat, somehow can be recovered. That is very important aspect. Let me tell you again, because it is very important to understand. For the first class, you prepare one video. Only for first class, you have to prepare an imaginary video without students. Very first class. And then share it with all the students. Now, next day when children are coming, they know what has been taught. Superficially, you have given some kind of idea of that particular subject and a student is coming to class. You are further discussing it, considering they have seen the video. So pace will be a little bit better. What students will do? They will watch this lecture at home and they will prepare questions for the teacher. So next day, mostly there will be question and answers and some explanations. At a school, those children have come to a school, they will ask questions and participate in learning activities. Now, what should be done before class? Now, out of the class, when they are at home, then they have to see the video. During class, they are in the class. So students get acclimated with new concepts and terminology via digital media. Students may take notes and jot down questions for further discussion. And when they are coming to school, students explore new concepts through learning activities, including peer discussion and even sometime 1:1 interaction with the teachers. And then after the class, student continue checking for understanding of the concept through higher order application and evaluation. And some homework is also given on the basis of that they can do. So this is a cycle, like the blue thing going here, coming here, this and here. So first time I'm asking, and please show me in the chat box with proper spelling. Aha.
Ho ho.
Nahi, abhi sirf likhna hai. Chat box mein likhna hai. Haan, I have started receiving. Oh ho, very good. All spellings are correct. Somebody has written oh. I think good. Spelling should be correct. That means your concentration is perfectly fine. Oh ho, very good. Very nice. That gives a lot of energy to me also. Now, what is after this, why we call it blended learning? In flipped classroom, blended learning is required because what is happening? Face-to-face training is going on and virtual classroom is also there for students sometimes. You can conduct some webinars also weekly. You can send them some links. Very nice thing is that you will find some links. And nowadays, so many links are available. Few links are provided by CBSE, few links are provided by NCERT. And there are so many links. And after this particular workshop, I, Mahajan sir, Sheeshan sir, and Parekh sir will share many links with you, which we are already having. And please remember, this complete presentation, I will be sharing with all of you. I believe in sharing knowledge. I don't want to keep that jadi booty with me so that only I can use. So do not try to make any kind of the photographs and all. But yes, one or two, I will tell that click it so that you will start working on that. So through our organization, we will send it to all. So links also you can send. Simulations means if you want to conduct some kind of experiment in the classroom, though with those students who are coming next day for practicals, then you can say some simulation video. This means in this video, somebody is doing in a video that particular experiment or activity which you are trying to conduct next day in the school. Then assessment, you know about it, and one-to-one coaching is also required, especially for those students who are special need students. So what is happening? There is a live time, there is a e-learning. So there are two parts, this part and this part. So live time, discussion time, synchronous connected time, feedback and improvement, screen time. This means there are two portions of this particular cycle. One is synchronous connected time and asynchronous guided time. So whenever you send video, send a little bit kind of a guided time that how you have to do this particular work. And sometimes you can give them project work, PBL, project based learning, which they can do at home at project based, which is known as project time. And there should be some time which is screen free and learning time. Let's move to next. blended learning checklist. This is very important. This is one of the slide which you can click also. Photograph you can click. So do the families. First of all, preparing students for distance learning. So do the families have a device that can access their children's curriculum? Check. Do the families have reliable internet services on Wi-Fi? Internet services. Provide the families with all the necessary login information, example code, links, etc., well in advance. If families do not have access to the necessary devices, mail or deliver hard copies of the instructional material projects to the student's home. This is first preparedness. Second one is access and communication. Verify that students are able to access the online learning platform. Stay in contact with the families through WhatsApp or whatever medium you have, and students regularly to update them regarding any changes via email, school website, social media, phone call, etc. So everybody should be updated. Document all communications, including phone call logs, emails, online meetings, attendance, text message, etc. Everything. Helping families and students transition. This means provide resources to families on how to help their children. This is very important. You know, whenever there is online education, so parent plays very important role, particularly in primary classes. Now I know even class 2 students can log in, class 1 can student log in and do lot many things. This took time, but here also we need help of parents. So provide resources to families on how to help their children have a smooth transition with remote training, remote learning, Google Classroom, Zoom, Canvas, LMS Learning, whatever it is there. This means conduct a webinar with parents and explain and send them a circular also in written form, so that if they face any kind of problem, they can always log in and they find it useful. Because you will find there are many parents who are not tech savvy, who are not computer savvy. So this is very helpful for them. Encourage parents to stick to a schedule such as e-learning time, outdoor time, core time, whatever the home course they want to do, chores, to help the children live a well-balanced lifestyle. So children should participate in house chores also. Every time they can help in parents and everybody in some kind of thing which you can make the part of project. Some families are not technology proficient. Make sure to have a FAQ resources and be ready to help troubleshoot issues. I asked this question in one of the workshop I took with Karnataka principals, and I asked them, anybody has made FAQ? Nobody made FAQ. So what was happening? Parents kept calling the class teacher, parents kept calling the computer IT person and all. So it is good to prepare an FAQ. You know it very well. CBSE gave one particular kind of exercise to prepare class 10th board result and lot many problems. And finally, when he came on CIER, forum and controller of examination just explained many things, he understood that FAQs are important, and then they sent different FAQs. So you know the importance of FAQ, and that will make a good rapport with the parents. Now, how to move it? This is again very interesting thing. So classroom learning, what is required? In classroom, there should be motivation. First of all, as I said, connect and then involve every student, because now less students are available in the classroom. One-to-one feedback, take, ask them personally that have you understood everything? Give them personal time and counseling, progress tracking, guidance, assessment and practice activities in classroom. So take feedback also, because now this is useful, because they are having some idea that what was given as an assignment for to get ready. Now online learning, those who are at home, tell them how to self-study, mobility, self-direction, how they can direct. If they are facing some problem in something, tell them to go on Google, write some notes and keep it as question next day. Self-tracking and control. Tell them how you are looking at everything, how you are making the complete day's timetable, self-tracking and control. Tell them that after every 20 minutes, there is a rule 20, 20, 20. After every 20 minutes, for 20 seconds, look at a project which is, or look at an object which is 20 meter ahead. Again, I'm telling. Ek aisa, har ek 20 minute baad, aapko 20 second ke liye 20 meter duri ki vastu dekhni hai. That is for eyes exercise. And second eye exercise is try to see infinite sign. I hope you would be knowing infinite sign. Infinite sign is like lying eight. Lying eight. So move your eyes like eight. Eyeballs will move like eight. This is also one very good exercise. And after every 20 minutes, tell students to breathe in and breathe out for 1 minute. Just 1 minute, breathe in, breathe out. Why breathe in, breathe out? I told them, one parent was asking, sir, why breathe in, breathe out? I said, very important thing is this, that when one child is studying continuously, concentrating, then the oxygen level in brain reduces. And when oxygen level in brain reduces, then it is very much required that you supply enough oxygen. Otherwise, child will have less concentration, less focus, as well as he might have headache. So the supply of oxygen goes after every 20 to 30 minutes also you can do, but not more than 40 minutes. So after 30 minutes, they breathe in and they breathe out, but breathe in such a way that your stomach is going in. Your stomach is going in. This means the real, your diaphragm is working and your lungs are working. So I'm giving you some kind of advice from science side also, which is very important. Then your children will be able to focus continuously. Now, just a minute. Now check one thing, level of instruction. First of all, tell them what is the unit, lesson, single course and entire curriculum. So make progression like this, that how you will be moving. What is time? Fixed daily schedule. Modify schedule whenever it is required. Open entry, open exit. Tell them that open, you can enter, you can exit until and unless you have certain kind of challenges in your school. What we have done in our school, that only that child can enter inside the classroom who is having the ID which has been sent by the school and which is in a school domain. So nobody from outside can enter and can create any kind of chaos. This is also important. Role of online components, enhance traditional instructions and transform traditional instruction. This is very simple. Whatever way you want to make discipline, teacher's role. Teacher leads instruction, teacher supports instruction, and no teacher involvement. This means there should be all three situations where no teacher involvement. Why? Because self-paced. It is very important, self-learning. Yesterday also, it was a very important topic which Anurag Tripathi ji touched, that there should be self-learning, self-paced learning, and self-understanding. Until and unless child will have that, it will be a kind of feeling that we want to make a small kid, tiny tot, running. And what we are doing every time, he is not leaving our finger, he is holding our finger, then he will never be able to walk. This means sometimes we have to leave. Aap mein se kai logon ne cycle chalana sikha hoga. When you would be learning how to cycle and your parent or elder brother was helping, most of the time he was holding the career, and all of a sudden he will leave the career and you won't know. Then you will gain confidence. Bhaiya, bhaiya, are you there? And you will find bhaiya is not there and you could bicycle without the support. So that thing is also very much required. What is the student role? Teacher driven. Whatever way teacher is telling, move. Teacher guided learning. Teacher is telling that first see this video, then see this link, and then try to find out what are your questions. Independent learning, I have already explained here. Student support, little or no support, depending upon you. School-based mentoring support means in every department, you for every day, you appoint one particular teacher who will be having a vacant period in between, who will be guiding students. Children will be calling him or her, and then he will be mentoring for any particular reason related to FAQs. School and home mentoring support, student to teacher ratio, traditional classroom ratio, 2-3 times traditional classroom ratio, or instructional help desk, whatever is possible, you can go with that. So this time, ah ha ha, chat box started. Yes, very good. Spellings are also correct. Mahajan sahab, dekhiye kitna badhiya. Ah, kuch gadbad aa rahe hain, kuch oho hi likh rahe hain sirf. Very nice, very nice. I'm counting, and whosoever will be absent, I will be asking him or her a question. So So Shishan sir, is it possible sometimes if I want to ask a question and somebody wants to answer, can answer that?
Yes sir. Possible.
Okay, now let us see this particular aspect. Wonderful. God bless you all, and I'm quite sure all of you will get more than 99% marks. What does it mean in your role? But remember that you will never be perfect in life. Always remember, you will never be perfect in life. Keep that thing in mind. Leave it to God so that he will keep guiding you to give that 1%, and that 1% is too big. Okay, now this is the whole process. How you proceed? Plan for 1/3 or half the content you normally do. Correct? This means now you have to keep the pace. That's why you have to divide according to the plan in your country, whether 1/3 or half students are allowed to come. Use the chat function in Zoom to take attendance. Don't ask this. All those students can give attendance. Like I ask you, I could have asked, devised some other formula also, and you could have done that. Next one is, try to talk in 8 to 12 minutes blocks, and then ask students to discuss in breakout rooms. This is very important. Breakout rooms, I'm quite sure many of you would not be knowing what is breakout room. Honestly, write no if you don't know, and yes if yes. We want to see how many are knowing. Mostly no is coming. I'm very happy to see your honesty. Few yes are also coming. No's are more. So please learn from your son, daughter, or friend what is breakout room. In breakout room, it is important. What is the use of breakout room? I will tell you in one slide, which is very beautiful. So in breakout room, there will be discussion. And meanwhile, I'm giving you one question. Okay. So whenever you are not concentrating actually on your screen, then you try to think, I will be giving you one work in between, when you will have to prepare one paper flower, means flower which is made by the paper. You have to think about it, and then I will be giving you this question to prepare. Don't start making. That time only I will tell you that make, because there will be one important thing I will tell you to do. Okay. After this, use one place to link and or embedded your digital tools. Most tools have embedding code. That is important. Ask for feedback from peers or groups after they have discussed in breakout room. It is very important that in classroom also, in breakout room also, you can make pair, one good student, one not good student, like that, or sometimes competitors or thinking. Give students time to socialize online and connect. This I will not say every time you do, depending upon the kind of students you have. So don't take it religiously. Now, what is important, this breakout also, I'm not telling you that do every day, but you do on alternate days. And one day in a week you keep for a special activity or this calibration work. Why it is important, I will tell you in another slide. So syllabus covering is also important. That's why keep that thing in mind. Try to have face-to-face video cameras on and use virtual background to protect data. Fine. Still continue to smile and laugh even though you may not hear or see your students. Okay. So teacher's body language is very important. You will find I'm smiling throughout. However, I can't see anyone because I have kept it on talking. I've reduced my screen of those participants to just one. Still continue to smile and be patient and kind to yourself in case technology gremlins visit. This is also important. Mahajan sir, mujhe classwork ka yaad dila dena beech mein. So now, what blended learning looks like. You know, generally you are using these Zoom, Google Meet, Microsoft Teams. I don't think many people are using Skype. There are some schools which are very rich in technology. They use Moodle, Schools LMS, Google Classroom, WordPress, Wix, Squarespace, and Blogger. I will tell you to take click of this particular page also. Now, what happens? First thing is connection. Connection means synchronous online face-to-face meeting once per week for one whole lesson, or twice per week for 25 minutes each, depending upon how you want to do. Sometimes what you can do that all the students one day are in school only, sorry, at home only, and then you are having direct connection or you are directly talking to all of them. This depends upon what kind of model is there in your particular country. What to do? Introduce and explain the task. This means you are explaining the task to all. Maybe that all of them will come for 10 minutes other than the school time. Remember, other than the school time, just for 10 minutes. Promote social and interaction and connection. Example, small group present, previous learning using breakout rooms also. Second is collaboration, learning experience for the week. What you are going to do could be a group project that lasts 2-3 weeks. Slowly, slowly they are doing. Then critical concept thinking. Here what happened? Online asynchronous discussions are going on. Post one prompt per week. Just one prompt. Students respond to prompt and comment on two others. Like I have given you prompt. What prompt I have given you? Make a paper flower. But I have not given you instruction. That instruction I will keep. You start thinking what kind of instruction I can give. Clarification. Answer questions. Clarify rooms. This means weekly clinic face-to-face or online. Like for KG students, every week I have one particular day for one particular class to have face-to-face interaction with the teacher, where one by one they come and they discuss, and sometimes discussion board with questions from students. Fine? Okay. Now there is a speed test. All right. Before this, I'm giving you the Bloom's pyramid, in which how we are dealing with this pyramid. Please see, this is the traditional model in which create, evaluate, analyzing, apply, understanding, remembering. I'm talking in a reverse order. So please don't mind. Students are responsible for homework in themselves and understanding these three parts. You know it very well. And teacher introduce new material to students, these two parts. Now what is happening in flipped model? This new material is introduced to students outside of classroom as their homework. This is not happening in the classroom. Understanding and remembering is not happening in the classroom. What is happening in the classroom? Now, applying, analyzing, evaluate, creating. See, complete role reversal, because here you are giving task to students to apply, analyze, evaluate, and creating. You know, many a times my master slide used to be, in life, most important thing is observation. Whole education depends upon how you can apply, how you can analyze, how you can evaluate is not very important, how you create. Because most of the people in India, great, great academicians in India say that education is acquisition of knowledge and applying. I had a tough discussion with them and then they agreed. Yes, sir, there should be further also, and that is creating. This means creation is also very important. So one speed test, okay? In this speed test, let me come to talking. This is 1 minute speed test on only 40 seconds speed test. Everybody should ready with pencil and pen. I will be asking you 7 questions. And in these questions, one of the questions will be very important instruction also. So be very careful. You have to follow the instructions. That can be very important. These are easy questions. So be honest, because you will be checking your question paper. And you have to answer as soon as possible, but you have to wait for the instruction, correct? Okay, the first question is, what is your surname? Understand, first question is, what is your surname? Second question, what is my name? My name means your present today is your teacher's name. Question number 3, what is date today? Date. Fourth question is, what is day today? And fifth question is, how many flowers you have made? Sixth question is, what is spelling of Pramod? Because you can see his name over there. And seventh question is, please attempt only question number 1. please attempt only question number one. I told you very clearly in the beginning that one of the question will be instruction, and you have to wait for the instruction question. All right. Now tell me, how many of you got trapped who have already written few questions answer in advance? So say no only. Those who got trapped, say yes only. I want to say yes. I want to see yes only. Yes, yes, yes. Good. So, Dolly ma'am, Dolly Bhatt ma'am, Shishan sir, Dolly Bhatt ma'am ko.
Dolly Bhatt ma'am.
Dolly Bhatt ma'am, unmute yourself. You can't unmute.
One second.
Yes. Yes, Dolly Bhatt ma'am, what did you learn from this?
We should listen carefully.
So you would have attempted many questions, correct?
All of them.
I told very categorically that you have to
listen. Three times you told precisely.
Yes, yes. So anybody who attempted only question number one, please raise hand and just please bring him or her on the screen. Yes, Mr. Manohar John Jose. आप इनको लाइएगा, मिस्टर मनोहर जोन जोस. यस मिस्टर जोस.
यस सर.
व्हाट वाज योर एक्सपीरियंस?
वेल आई हर्ड दैट यू आर गिविंग इंस्ट्रक्शन, सो आई वाज वेटिंग फॉर द इंस्ट्रक्शन, सो आई जस्ट जॉटेड डाउन द क्वेश्चन. दैट्स व्हेन आई गॉट नंबर 7. आई वाज लाइक, बट आई सॉ द आंसर्स कमिंग, आई वाज पैनिकिंग अ बिट, बट देन यू सेड प्लीज आंसर ओनली वन क्वेश्चन.
नाउ आई विल टेल यू, यू हैव आल्सो डन ब्लंडर. Clear? Please tell me honestly. We are trying. So, sorry. Have you attempted question one, question number one right now? Not yet.
Yes, I have.
What is that question number one answer?
What is your surname? John Jose.
You have written it, John Jose?
Yes, I have answered it there in the chat, sir.
Not chat. You were to write on. You were to yes, write yes. on paper.
Yes, yes. Yes,
Achal ma'am, Achal Khanna. So mostly what happens, people forget to even write that in great enthusiasm that sir has announced that most of you are wrong. Yes, Achal ma'am. Sorry.
Sir, good evening first. I haven't written the first question.
Yes.
Reason
yes.
being, it's my surname and I know it.
Correct.
So I didn't write it down.
Very nice. Very nice. I wanted to hear that only, honestly. Thank you.
Secondly, since in the beginning itself, you said, listen to the instructions. And since like the flowers, no instructions were given. So I didn't start writing it down.
Good, good. So both the things happened. One thing happened that you will start attempting all the questions. And when you will see in chat box also, you will say, oh, let me do all questions. And by the time last question comes and I say, whosoever has done all the question is wrong. So what happens in great enthusiasm, you will forget to write the answer of first question. So you are also wrong. Anyhow, it was nice to see the participation and honest participation. Let us move to next slide. And meanwhile, I hope everybody is. So please do not feel bad. Those who answered wrongly, you have learnt very important lesson in life. Again, which I told you in the beginning, please listen carefully. But like students, you also didn't listen carefully. And I'm sure third time when I will ask question, you will not listen carefully. But fourth time in your practical life, you will listen carefully. That is, I'm quite sure. That is my observation. So let me check. Ahaha. In chat box only you have to write. Oh, yes, started coming. Very nice. So now what is happening? What is the design? Designing is this, that remember, understand and apply outside of class means select content. Just a minute. Select content, select delivery method. What is your delivery method? How you will plan the whole process outside of class? What you will do? Select content. What content you have to teach? like lesson plan, select a delivery method. What will you do? Will you showing video? Will you be showing link? Will you be showing PPT? Will you be lecturing? Decide well in advance. Create or find the content. Then reflect. Reflection is very important. Is it good enough? Then in class, what you will do? Assess. Whatever was given here, try to assess that was useful, that was sufficient. When you will ask question or children will ask question, you will get to know what was the quality of your content, whether everything reached them or not. Select activity. What is activity that you want to do in classroom? Do it in classroom and every day keep one activity. Coach students. Analyze, evaluate, and create, and the process goes on. Learning outcomes goes on. So this is very important that here you reflect. And again, here you reflect whatever is given here. Because in lesson plan, I know most of you are not having this particular term reflect in your lesson plan at all. I have seen in all the schools I did not find, but in lesson plan always write those schools in which teachers are writing lesson plan. Last thing should be reflect. And this reflection will come after. This means you need not write reflection in advance. Reflection when you have taught in the classroom. After that, you go to staff room and write in today's classroom what was missing and what was great. So what was great, next time when you conduct the class on that particular topic, you add this was great. And what was missing, next time when you are conducting the class, class on that topic, write this was missing. So every time when you are preparing new lesson plan, that will be the best lesson plan or better lesson plan for the previous. So I request all the principals and particularly teachers add reflection at the end. That is very, very important. And this is missing everywhere in Indian education system. Now, advantage of flipping. I will not have more time on this. Promotes whatever are the usefulness that everybody knows. So I will move to next one. This is important. Why sharing is important. So with this particular story, who would like to explain? Please raise your hand. What do you understand from this? Anybody who raises hand, Shishan sir, just.
Yeah.
Nobody is raising hand. Please don't get scared. Yes, Shri Kala ma'am.
I don't know, I believe.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Shri Kala ma'am.
Yes, sir. I'm speaking.
Yes, please.
This is about four blind people who were asked to look at an elephant. Because they are blind, they are looking at each part by feeling, they are touching their hands. They are telling how an elephant looks. One of them, it is like a big sea. One may be saying it is like a trunk of a tree or something like that. Only when they share everything. Each one of them shares. They're all describing different parts.
Yeah, this person is saying that this is like a pillar, correct?
Tree, yeah, like a pillar, yes.
This person may be saying
it must be like a big, hand fan or something like that.
This person is saying and that this, it is like something like maybe the, what do you say, python or something like that, okay?
Yeah, like a snake, yeah.
This is like a rope. Now, yeah. Same situation is ours. If four people, if they are in a room, all four will be having different ideas of one particular aspect. Because we are not blind, but somewhere in visionary, we are blind. Nobody is perfect. Please remember, whatever you are looking in world, that is one side, one aspect of that particular problem, not everything. How to resolve? Now I give the solution. So King asked, what is elephant? And then all four answered wrongly. Correct? Christina, ma'am. Unko jara, Shishan sir, Christina, ma'am.
I will be doing it, sir.
Yeah, Christina, yes, ma'am.
Sir. Yes, so sir.
King asked these all four people. So they said, one said, oh, it's like a rope. Elephant is like a rope. Then one said, it's like a pillar. Another said it's like a fan. This said it's like a python. Now what happened further? You know, what happened that Christina ma'am was there in that particular court, King's court. Christina ma'am said, sir, allow me, I will get the answer. So she said, all four of you sit together and try to describe. All four sat together. And they said, yes, sir, this is the animal which has tail like this, which has a trunk like this, which has legs like this. This means in calibration, you can resolve any problem. Yes. So this is very important that in classrooms, all teachers teaching one particular topic or one particular aspect must calibrate, must have brainstorming. Otherwise, few are thinking that I'm correct because I can feel this. Or somebody will say, I'm correct. But all four of you are 1/4 correct, not completely correct. But if you come together, you are completely correct. So calibration is very important. This is very beautiful story, a very, very beautiful thing to explain for calibration, why calibration is important. And in school, all teachers will find it very interesting. And if you will have brainstorming in a school of same all teachers teaching same thing, you will find somebody will come for inclusion, somebody will give an idea of integration, somebody will give an idea of activity, somebody will give an idea, and you will have a perfect lesson plan. Am I correct? All those who think that I am correct will show thumbs up on not like Mahajan sir, kaise dikhate hain wo thumbs up? Aap dikhate ho aksar.
Like this.
Yes. All right. I would like to see how many thumbs up are there. Oh, Mahajan sir, aapka hi nahi dikh raha thumbs up. Wo nahi idhar wo dikha. Haan, ye wala thumbs up. See, I want to check how many of you don't know how to show this thumbs up. Archana ma'am, aapko nahi pata hai. Christina ma'am, you don't know how to show thumbs up. No, not this one. Like Mahajan sir, dobara dikhaiye. Yes, देखिए श्रीकला मैडम को पता है और सौमिनी मैडम को पता है और लोगों को भी पता है सब ये भी सीख लीजिए कि थम्स अप कैसे दिखाया जाता है. ओके, दिस इज वन मोर लर्निंग फ्रॉम यू. यस, ट्राई क्रिस्टीना मैम, यू विल गेट. महाजन साहब थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन करिएगा.
गो टू द रिएक्शंस, क्लिक इट, देयर विल बी फोर साइंस एंड यू कैन प्रेस एनीवन.
Could she do it?
Yeah, done.
Now see what kind of a smile is on her face, like a big achievement, a good round of applause from my side. But remember, these small achievements can give you a lot of happiness. Now, how happy Christina ma'am was, very happy. This shows that small aspects, small victories, you should enjoy, you should celebrate. Don't wait for big achievements. Small achievement also you celebrate. If you have made a beautiful flower, if you have made a wonderful vegetable, if you have made a wonderful dish, celebrate it. What a great thing. When you will celebrate, there will be more happiness. Your learning ability will improve. What else will improve? Immunity will improve. Abhi to corona mein sabse important immunity hai. Jitna aap hasenge, jitna aap khush honge, आपका इम्यूनिटी इंक्रीज होगा. लेट्स मूव फर्दर. नाउ दिस इज हाउ टू डू फ्लिप लर्निंग इन क्लासरूम. दिस इज माय मास्टर स्लाइड, वन ऑफ द मास्टर स्लाइड. सो प्लीज टेक अ क्लिक ऑफ दिस. डिवाइड द क्लास विद स्टूडेंट्स ग्रुप्स हैविंग सिमिलर लर्निंग चैलेंजेस. करेक्ट. प्रिपेयर वीडियोस, लिंक्स एंड स्टडी मटेरियल फॉर होम लर्निंग. For home learning, there should be different videos. Sometimes in classroom, there should be different videos. Please remember one thing. Don't teach one thing two times. Rather, when you are giving them this work, the pre-lesson work, let them come to school with that and ask questions. There should be more brainstorming. Prepare activities, practicals, and calibration for classroom. In classroom, when they come, then they should have calibration. They should have activities, preparations, and practicals, etc. Classroom learning, take feedback, reflect, and remediation. This is very, very important. Now, academic tools. You can take a photograph of this one also, because this is also very important. These are various tools which you can use. In my school, I have made it compulsory for all the teachers that whenever you enter inside the classroom, first of all, have quiz. 2 minutes quiz time on Kahoot, and there are many, many quiz platforms which are here. So first of all, as soon as you enter in the classroom, ask them questions, maybe 10 questions in which somebody is coming on the top, because there are in Kahoot and Edmodo and all, these are such kind of platforms which are free. When you are asking them questions, not necessarily ask questions every time from the subject. There should be few questions which are based on common sense, or few questions on the basis of what you can say, recapitulation. So 10 questions which are objective type of questions, A, B, C, D. So child is giving answer D, A, B, C, and then automatic scores come there. Sometimes if I will find time, I will conduct that particular quiz on this, or anybody, you will find it very interesting. All my children are waiting for quiz. They say, sir, quiz mein maja aa gaya. Quiz is very good, because there they have competition and they try to find out good answers. So these are all kind of equipments. Take a click, or after this workshop, have 1 hour, have good, have a good shower, and after shower, sit for half an hour and check on Google what are these all tools, and you can use many of these tools. Okay, so online groups, 1 period per week only activities. Don't take so too many activities if there are big activities and collaboration. Project-based learning. Peer teaching is also very important. Peer teaching, make some pairs where one peer student is helping another student outside the classroom. Outside the classroom means home, on Zoom meeting, half an hour. The best way to learn is teaching. Best way to learn is teaching. If you will teach, if your one student will teach one thing to some other student, he will become the master of that particular topic. So try and tell them that do this, that this topic you teach them, this is beneficial for you. Most of the parents think, why are you wasting time? Us ladke ko kyun samjha rahe ho, apna time waste kar rahe ho. No, you will become the master of that topic. I have done this experiment in one of the school. I was principal in Jaipur. It was Maheshwari Public School. And what I did, that class 10th students who cleared NTSC, I told them that all of you will teach next class 10th batch, and one hour I will give you. So there were 10 students. These 10 students were coming to me every time, sir, give me one hour class. Now NTSC student is teaching the students. He need not come to their level, very interestingly. And let me tell you can see the history. In 2005, all 10 ranks, first to 10 rank in NTSC were from my school. Next year again, from 1 to 10 ranks were from my school. In IIT, third rank, 10th rank, 21st means there were 5 to 6 ranks within 100. Why it happened? Because of peer learning. There was a lot of competition among children. They used to come and ask, sir, please give us some time. And they were preparing it like anything. So this is very important thing. Please, all of you, take it. Peer teaching. Apply and share. PPT presentation by student, about which Tripathiji also told about 9 to 12 projects, they must prepare PPT so that they gain confidence to present. Special need students, take special care also of gifted students. I have one student in class 3 who is appearing in all the exams of class 7. And he is getting 75-80% marks in mathematics especially. Role play, you know about role play, you know about skits, learn from home activity also. These are few more useful tools. So I will not speak on that. You take a snapshot of this particular site and you will find many of them are very useful for you. And you can always take care. So this is the time, Mahajan sir, that yes. They take a paper flower without folding the paper. Without folding the paper, make a paper flower, giving you 20 seconds. Very good. Somebody has written, when one is teaching, two are learning. Who is that? That is gone. Yes. Yes. Falguni Pathak ma'am. Very nice. crushing is not allowed. In that also paper folding. Done. Ruchi ma'am has done. Ruchi Maheshwari ma'am has done. Okay, I will give you a chance. Shishan sir, Ruchi madam ko jara. Rolling is also not allowed. Drawing is also not allowed. See, listening was important, right? I told you that you will not listen carefully. Cutting is allowed because cutting is not folding.
Okay. Hello, sir. This is Ruchi Maheshwari from Indore.
Tell me your flower.
Actually, I drew the flower on the paper.
I didn't say draw. I said paper flower. I have given you hint now. What is hint? That you can cut or you can tear. This is a flower, hai na? Isko aap apne haath se kaat lijiye. Hard lijiye. Is tarah se flower ban jayega. If simple paper is there, you try to tear it from one side, you can create a flower. Now I'm receiving done. Sheetal Rajput ma'am ko laiyega sir. Sheetal Rajput.
Yeah.
Yes, is Sheetal ma'am there?
Led by tearing, sir.
Show me the flower. Yes, good. Yeah. So Mahajan sir, जरा इनको एक वो thumbs up दे दीजिएगा.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thumbs up for you. I hope you enjoyed.
Thank you, sir.
Sheetal ma'am, I hope you enjoyed. So there was lot of thinking. Wow, clapping दिया है इन्होंने. Very nice. So in chat box, just tell me. Not in chat box. No problem. So just show thumbs up for everyone because now everybody has made it. Very simple is thumbs up. Very nice. Mahajan sahab, jara check karna, sabne diya hai, jisne nahi diya hai, unka naam bolna.
Srishan sir ne bhi diya abhi to.
I had a very small sheet of paper. I couldn't make it for the perfect one.
Yeah, Devinder Kaur madam, nice thumbs up with different color.
Yes. So this is creativity, sir. This is creativity. Very nice. So very good. I hope sab logon ne jo idhar nahi de pa rahe unhone idhar de diya. Dekho idhar bhi dhyan se nahi suna. These people did not listen carefully. They are giving me thumbs up in chat box. See that my instruction was not very good. So I will not differ from that. So this I hope you have already taken care of. So moving to next slide, there are few more tools. So take a photograph of that one also. Yes. Khan Academy, free you can get. Edmodo, Google Plus, Brain Pop, Teacher Tube is very important, very useful. Teacher Tube. I hope they have taken the photograph. Pick. Yes. Now conclusion and suggestions. Now before making it conclusion and suggestions, a very important thing is that when Shishan sir told me that you have to take this particular class, I'm telling you honestly that I was a little bit disappointed. Oh my God, I have to take a class on a subject about which everybody thinks that they are expert. Number one. And number two, they will think that, oh, we are doing it for 1 year. What new sir will tell? Third thing, I thought there will be no connection. And how will I take class? This was a big challenge. And I'm so happy that all my participants have encouraged me. They charged me with their answers. So this last slide is for all of them. I'm giving this credit to all the participants. And I will request participants one by one to explain one. So raise hand and then come. Sir will give you chance to explain one point, like first point, second point. So whosoever is raising hand, Shishan sir, give them chance to explain. Raise hand.
Yes, sir.
Anybody raised hand? Yes. So unmute, sir.
Now she can unmute from her side.
Okay, please unmute. But sir, there are 2% participants who have raised hand. Because first question is difficult question.
So may I?
Yes, please.
Fine, sir. The first one is consider your students' learning style.
Yes.
So every child has a different way of learning. One might be a rote learner. One might be an oral, like oral wise, he might be reading and writing. Mine might have a musical inclination and probably he'd be the one singing songs or making a rap and doing it in his style or her style. So we should always consider students' learning style. So if a child is inclined towards drawing something and presenting something as points, we should give that leverage to that child.
Nice, ma'am. I want a little bit more explanation. Mona Dalmia, ma'am.
Okay.
Unmute, ma'am. Nishina, ma'am, your answer was correct.
Right.
I want to go a little bit deeper. Yes, ma'am.
Right, sir. Like he said, there are different types of learners. We do consider, you know, if you look at Bloom's taxonomy or Michael Halliday's things and all, we also know that there are children who are visual learners, then there are children who are auditory learners,
yes.
There are children who are kinesthetic learners, and so forth. So when we are planning our lessons, I think it's a great idea. And now, especially with online learning and so much of the world is at our disposal in a way, you know, we can include all kinds of strategies so that all kinds of learning styles are able to, you know, sort of, we can enrich their learning experience through various methods and various mediums.
Thank you, Mona, ma'am. Very nice. Because these are different learning styles and that's why in a classroom, you need differential learning. You need differential instruction. That's why you go for different kind of questions and style. Anybody knows that this multiple intelligence, so who gave this theory of multiple intelligence? Yes, Achal Khanna, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Yes,
Howard Gardner designed this theory of multiple intelligence.
Yes. Oh, thank you very much. Good. So you can see Howard Gardner has given. So today you check that Howard Gardner's multiple intelligence theory is what. Now, second block. So I'm giving.
Sir, may I add something, please, really quickly? I want to highlight what you did in your lesson. You actually, so for somebody who's an auditory learner, like myself, I was able to listen to you and I was able to get everything. For somebody who's a visual learner, you had the slides up for them. It wasn't a blank screen where you were just talking. So you were thinking about the different learners who will be in your classroom today. You even made us like cut a paper or do something, you know, you were making us do some kinesthetic things, which were also keeping in line with the learning styles of your class. You know,
And you know, there was very important observation on a screen. When I saw many people, I saw you are very inquisitive. That's why I picked your name and you gave the answer. I think you did not raise hand rather, but I picked you from those. I could guess that you know the answer. So observation is also very important. When you look at child who is a little bit dull or who is prompt learning, there are 2-3 people who are continuously answering. So I will not give opportunity to them now. So for learn to use basic technological tools, Shishan sir, you can choose. Shishan sir, you can ask.
Yes, sir.
You can choose one person and tell her to unmute and explain.
I've done, sir.
Yes. But tell the name so that she can answer.
How many, ma'am? Ma'am, you can unmute from your side.
Yes, sir.
Yes, so many. You have got second chance. Learn to use basic technological tools. What are these technological tools?
I myself is learning, and I'm so excited to sit in your class to know many things. You asked to draw the petals. I have to draw the petals which no flower would ever have. Many petals, that much I am enjoying this. So to learn to use basic technological tools means I am very poor in technology, but still what I came to know is about learning, like using that Kahoot, that Mentimeter. But what makes me doubtful is, I am still in doubt. What is my doubt is, my I am teaching Hindi.
Yes, yes.
So in language, how can I bring all these things? And that's the reason why I go and keep on searching for, keep on going for in search of webinars, attend the webinars. Everywhere I can see the science subject coming in the top.
No, no, I have given all subjects. Like what can happen, ma'am? In Hindi, you can do an exercise. जिसको कहा जाता है कि नेट बनाइए, आप कहिए बच्चों को एक स्टोरी सुनाए, इंग्लिश वाले हिंदी वाले, वो कहे कि एक स्टोरी सुनाए, एक स्टोरी कैसे शुरू करें, पहला बच्चा पहला सेंटेंस बोल रहा है, आपने उस बच्चे को कहा कि अच्छा आप बताइए आपको अमेरिका न्यूयॉर्क जाना है तो क्या हुआ, पहले बच्चे ने कहा यस मैं इंग्लिश में बोल रहा हूँ, आप हिंदी में भी कर सकती हैं, आई टुक अ कैब एंड देन आई स्टार्टेड आई रीच्ड एयरपोर्ट, नाउ सेकंड चाइल्ड हैज टू स्पीक, सेकंड चाइल्ड सेड when I was waiting for my plane, I saw that Madhuri Dixit is sitting next to me. So interesting, they're making interesting. The third one said something else. Fourth one is saying that I entered in the airport and I saw that who the air hostess who was serving, she was next door neighbor to me. Now I did this exercise in a principal's workshop. And very interestingly, one principal tried to sunk my ship. Correct. Sink my. So what he said, there were 15 people were left to participate. He said, and then all of a sudden, what happened? My plane crashed and just went into the sea. Now I have to continue with, and I had continued. What should I say to continue this story to next? This is question for everybody. If anybody wants to answer, please raise your hand. आप समझ गए? उसने क्या कहा कि भाई हमारा जो एरोप्लेन था वो डूब गया, अब तो स्टोरी खत्म हो गई, आगे वाला क्या बोलेगा? फोर पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैव रेज्ड हैंड. शीशन सर जरा चूज करिए, इट्स गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग.
या शालिनी मैम इज देयर, शी कैन.
यस शालिनी मैम,
यू कैन अनम्यूट फ्रॉम योर साइड.
थैंक यू सो मच सर. इट वाज रियली एन एंगेजिंग you know, session altogether, but I would like to help Soumya ma'am, who just raised the question on Hindi. Ma'am, there is a wonderful platform known as Vocaloo, where you can record. So I have used that in my English, being an English teacher, I've used that in my English lesson classes, where for especially for listening task and for speaking task. So I think you can use that platform of Vocaloo. You can record the activity. You can send worksheets, so your listening task is taken care of. You can also use Vocaloo for recording.
Shalini ma'am, give your number to that Hindi teacher and calibrate.
Even she can put that in chat box also, the name.
So now answer to that question, that now how can I continue my story? Anybody raise hand, please. Seven participant raise hand. I can't see, sir. Problem is this. So
yeah, there's something is flickering. Yeah, but something.
Yeah, please. Yeah, Deepika Arora, ma'am. Please unmute.
Deepika,
and next question will be from Nirmala Thakur, ma'am. You should get ready, ma'am. Deepika Arora. Yeah, please. What to say?
Maybe I would have continued the story as that. That is when my mom woke me up.
Ah, very good. Very good. That was the answer. That was the trick I used. That I said my next, the person who was sitting next to me, he just pushed my shoulder and I woke up. My God. So it was not. So now a story will come again. So you will find that there will be certain kind of a student who will try to drowning your ship. But you should find out the way with your presence of mind to get away with that.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you, sir.
So, yes, ma'am, Nirmala Thakur, ma'am, this third one, yellow one. Plan in detail what to do inside and outside the classroom. Just please explain. Nirmala Thakur, ma'am.
Ma'am, you can unmute now. I mean, that you, the mic, you can unmute.
Yes. In detail, what to do inside and outside the classroom. This is a very successful way of doing, and sir, you have explained it very nicely. I have used it several times and I have seen excellent results, especially in social studies and of course in science, but it works the best in social studies.
Yes, yes, yes. Very correct. So inside and outside, what you want to say, you have to decide. Like,
can I take some time and explain it?
Please.
See, suppose a difficult chapter like social studies, which has of revolution, suppose, and in grade 5 you have to teach, and it's a very boring lesson which the students generally don't want to read. They want the teachers to do all the reading and writing notes. So there we bring in a lot of new elements. You tell on a weekend, divide the class into 4, and on the weekends you ask them, you give them a list of movies to see. So they make their groups and they watch the movies. Say some may watch on French Revolution, some may watch on Russian Revolution and the various revolutions. The following weekdays, in the first day, we have make a chart on the board, and then the students, you know, discuss. So this can be done on Zoom also. Basic questions could be, who were the main leaders in the revolutions? Then major incidents which happened.
Yes.
Then how the closure of the revolution happened.
Thank you. So real learning is happening right now. So,
and then what happens? And based on this, once they have already put in, so what happens? The whole class has been discussing four revolutions, and then the picture and the class dynamics is very great. Then you tell them, now you read the text, and then whatever is happening in the current situation, can you relate that? So we got excellent results, and I think many students of grade 5 were discussing the revolution which was happening in Turkey at that point of time when I was staying in Dubai.
Yes, so thank you, ma'am.
I think
thank
it
you.
Works, you know. The lesson becomes very, very easy.
Thank you, Nirmala ma'am. Now one of my very good friend is there, Dr. Arogya Reddy ji. This one, choose an appropriate activities. Arogya Reddy sir.
Yes sir. Good evening everyone. Good evening sir ji.
He is a great academician. Yeah, please.
Sir. Fine. So yes, choose appropriate activities. Again, will relate to the first slide, which is consider the learning styles of your students. That's a one category we can look at. I think already many of them have given examples of visual learner, kinesthetic learner, auditory learner, nature learner. I mean, you name those 9 multiple intelligences, or rather 10 now of Howard Gardner. We will have to design musical as well. The other aspect that we need to look at also is the capacity of the children. There are gifted and talented, there are SEN in the sense special needs, as well as students with the special talent. So even those mixed ability groups also we will have to look at. If you give a simpler activity, the gifted and talented will finish it in a span of seconds, and then he might disrupt the whole class. Vice versa also, if you give a difficult task to a special needs, or maybe rather a person who needs a lot of support, he might struggle with it and he might distract the whole class by asking for frequent help. So we'll have to balance all the activities. Thank you, Sergey.
Thank you, Reddy sir. So in this first block and fourth block, only difference is first block is how to teach them. Second is what activity you will choose for different kind of students. I'm telling you, I will be taking one workshop, one particular webinar on elementary education, in which I will be explaining that those early finisher, what to do with them. Most of the teachers, what do they do? Ma'am, humne kar liya, ma'am, humne kar liya. Acha, head down. My God, telling that child head down, this means you are bringing him down. There are so many activities. You can give him puzzle, you can give him some artwork, you can give him so many things. But please do not tell any child to head down in the classroom. That is very ridiculous. So take care of this. Let us move to now this one. These 3 next slides are different. So special assistance to special need students. Anyone who wants to explain? Or I will pick someone. नहीं आचल खन्ना मैम आप पहले बता चुके हैं तो I will take someone else. Sorry.
Also,
may I?
उषा पाठक.
No, this is Jnana Panditan.
Please, you carry on.
Yeah. Yes. Special assistance to special needs students. So this could be like children with some learning difficulties or children who have certain difficulties which has to be
taken care of and which needs to be addressed.
Yeah. So this could be for children who required some special assistance. Maybe dyslexic students or children who have problem in expression. There are children who have nowadays a lot of difficulties. Children with a lot of difficulties are often found in the classes when we do the diagnosis. So in such cases, we can provide them, instead of just going on with the routine activities, there can be some special works given to them, which will keep them engaged. Activity which will make them feel they're also part of the class. Because for them, the normal mode of teaching may not suit. It may make them feel they were left out in the class.
Thank you. Being sensitive and addressing that. Thank you very much. This means we have to prepare different tasks and such kind of tasks that these child also have a sense of achievement.
Correct.
Sense of achievement is very important. Give them some task where they feel there is sense of achievement. Now, I will not talk about effective assessment. I will ask about this. This is very important. So, Dr. Usha, I think, if you are there, Usha ma'am, then please unmute and come. I think she is not there, or maybe that I read the name wrongly. Anyone who is interested, this is very interesting.
Seema ma'am is there. Seema ma'am, you unmute from your side, please. Seema ma'am, your mic is off, ma'am.
And after this, I will be giving one activity, so get ready.
Seema ma'am, you can unmute from your side.
Achha, she was Dr. Uma Bhalerao. Yes, anyhow, we will take two. Seema ma'am,
please unmute Seema ma'am. I think she's not able to do it from her side. One second, ma'am. But usually you can do it.
Okay, by the time.
The other name is Usha, sir. I will check that, ma'am.
Dr. Uma Bhalekar, ma'am.
Oh, yeah. I remember seeing her.
Oh. And Gayatri, ma'am, raised hand.
Okay. Yeah, you can speak, ma'am. Gayatri, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah. So we are talking here about the special assistance to special needs students.
No, ma'am. We are talking now about curriculum alignment and gap analysis.
I'm sorry.
Okay, no problem. No problem, ma'am.
One second, sir.
There are some raised hands, but they have already answered questions. And so, sir, any raised hand? Four parties.
Sir, Sunita ma'am, you want to answer?
Sir, may I?
Yes, please.
Yeah. So we are talking about curricular alignment and gap analysis. So here, when you talk about the alignment of curriculum, so we should plan it such a way that anyways, based on CBSE, they give us the curriculum, fixed curriculum. We'll have to go with that only. But then according to our students, we could see which is suitable. We could align the chapters as per our convenience.
Yes, yes.
And the students need and necessity also to be taken into consideration.
Yes, yes, yes.
So it's not that I teach real numbers first, then the polynomial, since I'm a math teacher. Because now the online classes are happening. If I start off real numbers in the starting itself, it's quite a vague concept.
Okay.
But then since polynomials is a continued chapter from class 9, if I start off with polynomials and take the confidence of the students,
good.
It will boost their confidence level. And then I start off with real numbers, it will help them. So this is how we could fix the gap also over there. And very, I feel this is
so now I will talk about primary classes. In primary classes, what alignment we have to do? We know in many classes what happens, that there are some lessons on Diwali, Eid, and national festivals and all. There is
in the month of August, since Independence Day comes, so yes, you could see the chapters which are correlated with Independence Day, and you could give a role play to the students.
Exactly. Very nice. So you have to align according to season. Don't teach children the summer story of English in class 9 or 10, I don't know, the story on a poem on summer in the month of winter. Automatically, this will be an experiential learning when you will be teaching them Diwali during Diwali days, if you will be teaching 15 August, 15th August during Independence Day and all these kind of things. So that alignment is also important. Gap analysis is a big thing, so I will not touch that right now. There are two slides more. So now I would like to see that how many flowers you have made. So put in chat box, whichever I will get more, I will be announcing their names, that how many flowers you could make. Just put in chat box the number. And I'm so happy that in the beginning, there were from where we started, there were 206 people. Till end, there were 206. In last discussion, it gone a little, it reached to 195, but no problem. Maybe those 11 people would be having some work. I'm so happy.
Must be the network issue, sir, I believe. You know, sometimes many people are going and coming out.
So my good round of applause to everybody. Four from Shyamala ma'am, Christina ma'am, 7 flowers. Kalpana ma'am, 5 flowers. Jaya ma'am, 2 flowers. And Jayatri ma'am, 5 flowers. Surbhi Pandey, 5 flowers. 5 flowers, 1 flower, 6 flowers. Very nice. And I can see there are few teachers, they made 1 flowers, but their number of petals are many. They could have made with these petals 10 flowers, 6 flowers, very nice. So thank you very much, Srisan sir or Mahajan sir. If somebody wants to ask any questions, you can allow them to ask.
Yes, sir.
So once again, good evening to everyone. Now the question, the forum is open for the questions. You can write a question in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and ask the questions. Before I propose the vote of thanks, your questions are most welcome. Remember one thing, you have to fill up the feedback form, and there are many such type of interesting sessions are there starting from today. So next session is for design thinking. After that, 25 techniques of teaching, talking less. So you can register for those sessions also. And remain a step ahead in the field of education. So the questions are most welcome. Achil Khanna ma'am.
Yes, sir. Good evening once again, sir. As in the beginning, you had discussed about, as the session is about flipped classrooms, and one of the slides here talks about grouping the students as per their needs. We do understand that online session has its own limitations, but then once these students are grouped, do you think the output would be the same once they come back to the regular classes? Because the ones, since in the classrooms it's always a heterogeneous group that we are talking about or catering to.
I understood, ma'am. There are two thought of schools. There is one thought of a school which always tells that there should be heterogeneous group. In physical classroom, I always advocate heterogeneous. But here what happens, you will find that children are coming for less time. And then you have to cover syllabus. So what you can do, that you can utilize that time, when the time which you can save from one particular group. And if one particular group, same kind of group is coming, you know what to teach and how to teach that. You won't be able to do differential learning in physical classroom. That will be a problem. But there is another school thought. In few schools, what they happen, they have these ability classes, A, B, C, D. What happens in accelerated learning, in any classroom, the real education goes only 30 to 40%. What does it mean? When teacher is teaching high caliber things, then those students who are average and below average, they are not understanding anything. Similarly, when teacher is teaching low level things, then all these brilliant students, they are wasting time and trying to trouble the class. That is second school of thought. So what I propose that during online, try to make such kind of groups, not offline. Offline is your choice how to do. Because in remediation, what happens that all children, you are teaching them at same level. You know that these students need remediation and you are teaching them at same level. So the pace will be better and children will be able to understand. There will be competition among these children. And you will find some winners from even remediation.
But sir, still I have another thought here. Because as we all are from the same fraternity and we all think alike, you know, ultimately it's the benefit of the student. But when it comes to online and these kind of grouping is done, definitely a parent might not accept it and it will be difficult for us to explain to the parent. Because if there are two students, let's say A and B, and A is intelligent, highly gifted student, and B is an average child, if they are put into different groups, B's parent might raise issues and which might be difficult for us as teachers to handle.
No, as I told you, there are two schools of thoughts. I told you now, but in online, what is happening that you are telling them same content. You are giving them same question paper. You are teaching them same material. Only thing is the level of discussion are different somewhere. And if it is not possible, then make two groups of all the students and special need students separately. This is your choice, correct? Yes, Thank you. Next question.
Next question. Unmute yourself and ask the question, please.
Sir, can you throw some light on this online synchronous discussion and asynchronous discussion?
It is only the word which is a very, very difficult word. Otherwise, discussion is the live discussion when everybody is face to face. Asynchronous is when. Yes, sorry. So asynchronous is when students are having discussions in different kind of divided rooms online or online. They are discussing and coming to certain kind of conclusion. So that term is given in the academic field like that. Otherwise, these discussions should be both times. Means it should not happen that when children are online, then they are unable to discuss or brainstorm each other.
Right.
Thank you, sir. So very nice, everything. And I can give you my email ID and my phone number. If you have any kind of query, you can ask me. My email ID is AP Sharma. You can see my as per name, 63@gmail.com. Email ID is very simple. And my phone number is, I will give Indian phone number, WhatsApp, 9818. 99336. I repeat, 9818. 99336. Thank you. Over to Pramod sir.
Sir, one small request, Mohajan sir. Yeah. But Deep, I mean, like Seema ma'am, at that time she wanted to ask something. We couldn't unmute her. Now we were. I think she can.
No, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Sharma, sir, that you have thrown light on the flipped classroom. There was a lot of confusion between flipped and blended learning. Because there is another confusion that we have in our mind, that is there something called blended curriculum or is it only blended learning? Because when we talk about this blended, there are two things which move around. One is the curriculum and one is the learning. So what is it that needs to be tackled or how can we understand this particular difference?
Yes. So Seema ma'am, blended word is a very universal word. This is used in different kind of frame of references. What does it mean? Blended means whenever you are trying to blend two kind of teaching. So one is like in flip classroom, you use blended learning that few children are online, few children are offline. You are doing activities with few children and another children, you are doing some other activities. Curriculum blending is different. Curriculum blending is very popular nowadays when you do the gap analysis. How you do the gap analysis, that suppose you take one particular chapter of science, maybe that the elements, and you pick up another curriculum, means Swedish curriculum or IB curriculum, and you try to see that what are different kind of things available over there, and you can make your curriculum. Now this time NCERT will come with the curriculum, but guidelines, but what happens, different books prepare, booksellers or publishers prepare different kind of books, and we think this is the syllabus. Not at all. You can blend it for the integration, you can blend it for the inclusiveness, you can blend it for different kind of courses, you can blend it for various activities. So blending is a term which is used in academic field for various reasons, you have told correctly. So that any kind of technology have various terms. Only we have to concentrate on that, what tools we want to use and what procedure we want to use. Need not that that particular thing has a specific name. Anybody can have any specific name. Fine, Simon.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yes.
Srishan, sir, you can post the feedback form in the chat box.
But my round of applause for all the attendees, and it was very good. So lastly, I'm just asking, oh ho ho.
Ha ha ha. So thank you, Sharma ji. Today's session was great, very interactive. And really, it was flipping one, flipped the thought process, flipped the style of presenting the webinar, and flipped the way of asking the question. All were active learner rather than active responder. They were reflecting a lot. Content was great. Presentation was great. And that we were expecting from a great personality. So thanks a lot. And definitely, days to come, we will have many more sessions with you. Dear participant, stay tuned with CEIR. We are there to uplift, to upskill, to transform. And remember one thing, we do it together. We do it together. We will and we can. The last request is, keep on registering yourself for the coming sessions. They are also equally good, or rather than we can say, every day you will find out a better version of ours, better version of webinars, better version of questioning skill, and better version of contents. Don't forget to fill up the feedback form, because your feedbacks guide us, scaffold us for the betterment to reach that level which is not known to us also. So we are finding out where we have to reach. That with that futuristic aspect, with that futuristic will, requesting you to fill up your feedback. Once again, thanks a lot, Sharma ji. And yes, jaisa aapka naam hai, aapne gyan ka prakash diya aur sabko anandit kiya. So isi anandmay palo ke saath request karta hu Srishan sir se. अपना फाइनल कमेंट्स दें एंड देन वी कैन क्लोज टुडेस सेशन व्हिच इज गिविंग अ स्माइलिंग डायनामिक्स इंश्योरिंग द स्माइलिंग डायनामिक्स ऑन ईच एंड एवरीबॉडीज फेस अदरवाइज एट द एंड ऑफ द वेबिनार एवरीवन लुक्स लाइक अ टेंस वन बट टुडे ऑल आर स्माइलिंग एंड दैट इज द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ टुडेस सेशन थैंक यू वेरी मच श्रीशन सर
एंड
वन सेकंड या
श्रीशन सर May I just talk to AP sir for a second? AP please. Sir has asked one question about R, smart ka R.
Relevant.
We had to tell him what is R, that is relevant.
Relevant is old dated now, realistic.
Realistic. Actually, if it is not relevant, then realistic will not come.
Resilience. So no, see, that smart, everyone has to define.
Yes.
In a different way. And that is the smartness. Everyone has to define smart different way. Today different, tomorrow different.
Yes,
and
sir.
Then tomorrow when you are different, defining the smart in a different way, forget what you have defined yesterday.
Exactly.
That is the learning aspect.
What next?
Yeah.
No best practice, next practice always.
R is rolling. R is not stagnant. It is rolling.
Yeah, it is rolling. Great. It is rolling. It is raising.
In today's webinar, Shishan sir, 50% of the things were those which I didn't anticipate. It came directly that time only, and I put this into this.
Okay.
And another great thing is all these slides, the complete PPT will be shared with you. It is $200,000 PPT, and you are getting in 200 rupees only, and that to Indian rupees.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Sir, can you share the attendance link once again, please?
Yeah, feedback link, Srishan sir, feedback link is